Hey everybody, it's Justin. Welcome back to the BTR Garage. Today we're going to be doing a little bit of work to my 1994 325IS. This is my full-time track car. I actually just got my time trials evaluation completed with the NASA Auto Club, so we're ready to take this car into time attack and time trials. So we're trying to get it set up here in the off season, get some work done to it, but first we gotta make sure that the engine is in good shape. So this video is actually gonna go over a compression test for the engine. And from there, once we figure out if the engine is good, we can go forward with the rest of the upgrades and modifications that I wanna do during the off season. So we're gonna show you how to do that particular process. Let's go ahead and get started. Now to get started, the first thing we have to do is get all of the spark plugs pulled out of the engine. We need to get these little clips pulled up right here, these little silver clips, they just slide right up. And we can pull the plugs out of the little ignition harness. So we do that for each one of the plugs. Next, grab your wrench with a 10 millimeter socket on it. We're gonna use that to loosen all of the nuts on the little ignition packs on each one of the cylinders. With all of the nuts loosened up, we can now start sliding the coil packs. They just kind of pull straight out. Pretty straightforward. I do like to keep them in the order that they came out. So we'll just lay them over here onto the intake manifold. Next up, we'll grab our wrench with an extension on it and a spark plug socket, and we're going to remove all of our spark plugs. And again, making sure we keep them in the proper order that they came out. All right, now that we have the spark plugs and the ignition packs out of the car, we're gonna take that stuff off of the engine, move it over to the bench. The next thing we have to do is actually get at the fuse box here and take out the fuse for the fuel pump. We don't want any fuel pumping into the engine when we're cranking it over doing the compression test. So we'll locate the fuel pump fuse in the little fuse panel reference, and it is fuse number 18. And again, looking at the fuse panel reference down here, fuse number 20 is right there. So we got 19 and 18. So we're gonna remove this little blue fuse that is our fuel pump fuse and set that aside. Now I have everything moved over to the bench here. We'll get this stuff cleaned up, the spark plugs and the ignition coils before they go back into the car. Now we can go ahead and start with the compression test. So this is our compression testing tool. It's just a little gauge, as you can see, with a hose attached to it and an attachment to screw into the spark plug hole. It comes with a few different size adapters for different size spark plugs and different types of vehicles or even motorcycles if you want to use it. So what we'll do is actually remove this quick disconnect on here, take the hose off, and then we can stick this into the first cylinder and then go ahead with the compression test process. So here we go. Take our hose, slide it down into place and start threading it in. Get that hand tight and then put our gauge back on to the end. Now, once we get to this point, you can just set your gauge off to the side as shown here and leave it as is. And then what we're gonna do is actually jump into the car and start the compression test process, which basically means we're gonna put the gas pedal to the floor and then crank the ignition over for about 5 or 6 seconds. What that will do is fill up the gauge with pressure readings. We'll come back out and see what it is at. We'll record that number and then go down the cylinders all the way to the back of the car and basically rinse and repeat till we get every cylinder tested, and then we'll compare the numbers at the end. All right, we're in the car. We'll go ahead and give this a shot. So key in, clutch in neutral, so gas pedal to the floor, and we'll crank it over for 5 or 6 seconds. All right, that sounded kind of nasty. Let's go check and see if we got any readings on the gauge. All right, so it looks like everything worked okay. I do have some pressure on the gauge. It looks like right around 150, a little bit higher than 150 reading on the gauge. So what we'll go ahead and do now is take the compression tester out of there. Actually, we want to bleed the gauge before moving on. There's a little button just like a tire pressure where you push and it bleeds the air out of the gauge. So make sure you do that between each cylinder. So we'll go down, do the rest of the cylinders in order. And again, we're going to record the values on my little chart over here and then see what we have at the end. All right, everybody, the compression testing process is complete. Everything looked good so far at an initial check, but I'm gonna go ahead and throw everything back together real quick, put the spark plugs in and the ignition packs back on. I cleaned everything up. Everything looks fine. So we'll get that back together and then take a look at the data itself. So naturally, I forgot to start the time lapse when I put everything back together, but basically it goes back together the way that it came apart. Again, you wanna make sure you put the spark plugs back into the holes that they came out of, and then the ignition packs also into the same spot that they came out of. We also don't want to forget to reinstall our fuel pump fuse, which is this blue guy here in the number 18 spot, like so. And now we can go ahead and get to the results of the compression test. All right, so I have recorded all of the values from my compression test on this piece of cardboard here. Each cylinder has its own value. Now the compression test is basically going to tell us how healthy our engine is. What you want to see with a compression test is all of your numbers for each cylinder should be roughly the same or within a certain percentage of each other. If you have a number that is really, really low compared to some of the other numbers or some of the averages, that's going to tell you you have a problem in that cylinder. Likely the piston rings have worn out and it's not holding any compression in that particular cylinder. Therefore, you have a lower compression test value. So looking at my compression test results, for the number one cylinder in the front of the car, we have 171. For number two, we have 170. For number three, on the high end, we have 178. Number four is showing 160 PSI. Number five, 169, and again, 160 on number six. I went ahead and redid the tests multiple times for each cylinder just to get a good level of baseline for each cylinder or a good average, and then recorded them here. And again, what we're looking for in these results is that our low end on the compression test and our high end on the compression test are not too far apart. So my low end is at 160, my high end is at 178. So an 18 PSI difference roughly between the low and the high. Everything else is pretty close. So that is really good. The compression tester manual actually says your low end should be at least 75% of your high end. And when we do the quick math on my numbers, 160 divided by 178, we end up with 89%. So 160 is 89% of the 178, so we're in good shape. If we're going below that 75% value, you know that is not good. In other words, if I had a cylinder here that read about 130 PSI and my high end was at the 178 PSI, that 130 PSI cylinder is only 73-ish or 74% of the high end. So we have a big gap between what the norm was or what the high end was and that really low cylinder. So therefore you can kind of deduce that you have a problem in that particular cylinder. Your engine's not going to run as well. It's not going to make the power that it should be making, and it's probably time for a rebuild. So there we have it for the E36 compression test. Things are looking good on my motor. For 207,000 miles on this engine and all of the abuse that I've put on the car through autocross and track driving over the years, it's holding up pretty well. The bad news is I can't swap an M3 engine into it just yet. I'm gonna run this one pretty much until it's dead. We'll see how long it goes. It might be a while. So the next issue that I gotta troubleshoot on this car is the clutch. I've had a lot of issues with the clutch slipping out on the track. Even just starting out in first gear, you can tell it's slipping and not holding power very well. So either the clutch is bad or we have oil leaking onto the clutch from the crankshaft seal. So we're gonna have to drop the transmission out of the car either way to find out. We're gonna be doing that here in the near future. All right, everybody, we're gonna wrap it up. Compression test process for an E36 BMW. This process applies to pretty much any other type of car as long as you have easy access to where the spark plugs are, and you know how to shut off the fuel system so we're not squirting fuel into the cylinders while we're doing the compression test. I'll put some links down in the description for the compression tester tool that I used. You can also find them at your local auto store. Sometimes they even rent them out as well. And I hope you all enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful and you learned a little bit of something. If you have any thoughts or comments, leave them down below as well. I'd love to hear from you. Like I said, stick around for more videos on the E36 BMW. Hopefully we've got a lot of stuff happening with this car this off season. So stick around, stay fast out there. I am checking out. Talk to you all next time.